الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين صلى الله عليه وسلم. Praise be to Allah and may His peace and blessing be upon His Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Thank you very much for joining us on this short video. Today, inshallah, I want to share with you some information from the Holy Quran that you can use to explain to the people that we come in contact with how does the Quran refer to the Christians and the Jews. As you know, these days we hear the word infidel or kafir used very commonly throughout. There are even car stickers that says kafir, infidel. So for one reason or another, Christians and Jews around us in our community have been taught, have been told that the Muslims refer to them as kafir. Now, if we look in the Holy Quran, we'll see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, throughout the Quran, for example, chapter 3, verse 65. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لِمَا تُحَاجُّونَ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمَا أُنزِلَتِ التَّوْرَاةُ وَالْإِنْجِيلُ إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instructing Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the believers, how to talk to the Christians and the Jews. The title is, Ya Ahl al-Kitab. Ahl al-Kitab. People of the book. That is because Muslims believe in the Torah of Musa, peace be upon him. Muslims believe in the Gospel of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, which is called the Injil in the Quran. However, Muslims believe in these books in their authentic format as they were revealed from God on Moses, from God on Jesus, peace be upon him. So we refer to them, the Quran refers to them as Ya Ahl al-Kitab, O people of the book. Why do you argue about Abraham when the Torah and the Gospel were not revealed until after him? Will you not reason? Another example from the Holy Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instructing the believers how Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the believers, how to talk to the Christians and the Jews especially. So it's important to understand that when Muhammad, peace be upon him, was around, him and the believers lived in a society that included Arab pagans who worshipped idols, plus some Jewish tribes, plus some Christian people. And so in the Quran, when the Quran refers to the Arab pagans, the reference uses pagans or kuffar or infidels. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the people of the book, the Christians and the Jews, they are referred to by Ahl al-Kitab, people of the book. Another example. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه فآمنوا بالله ورسله ولا تقولوا ثلاثة انتهوا خيرا لكم إنما الله إله واحد سبحانه أن يكون له ولد له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا. This is chapter 4 verse 171 in the Holy Quran. In Sahih International, the translation reads, O people of the book, do not commit excess in your religion or say about God except the truth. The Messiah, Jesus, the son of Mary, peace be upon him, was but a messenger of God. And his word, which he directed to Mary, and a spirit from him, created by a commandment. So believe in God and his messengers, and do not say Trinity. Desist. It is better for you. Indeed, God is but one God. Exalted is He above having a son. To Him belongs whatever in the heavens and whatever is on earth. And sufficient is God as a disposer of all affairs. So even when the Quran is talking to the people of the book about the divinity, the true position of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, even then, Allah refers to the Christians and the Jews as Ahlul Kitab, people of the book. Chapter 5, verse 15. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أهل الكتاب قد جاءكم رسولنا يبين لكم كثيرا مما كنتم تخفون من الكتاب ويعفو عن كثير قد جاءكم من الله نور وكتاب مبين. O people of the book, there has come to you our messenger, Muhammad, peace be upon him, making clear to you much of what you used to conceal of the scripture and overlooking much. There has come to you from God a light and a clear book. Another example, chapter 3, verse 64. Again, قل, say, a command to Muhammad, peace be upon him, and all the believers of Islam. قل, say, يا أهل الكتاب تعالوا إلى كلمة سواء بيننا وبينكم ألا نعبد إلا الله ولا نشرك به شيئا ولا يتخذ بعضنا بعضا أربابا من دون الله فإن تولوا فقولوا اشهدوا بأننا مسلمون. O people of the book, come to a word that is common between us and you, that we will not worship other than God and not associate anything with him and not take one another as lords instead of God. But if they turn away, then say, bear witness that we are Muslims. This verse in the Quran, chapter 3, verse 64, clearly commands Muhammad, peace be upon him, and all the believers and all the Muslims to come to the people of the book and say, and propose. Ta'alaw means come. Let us come together to a common word between us and you that we worship none other than God. Then it says, should the people of the book decide not to accept this invitation, what should we do? Say to them, the Muslims are to say to the people of the book, to the Christians and the Jews, bear witness that we are Muslims. No compulsion in religion. If you do not want to accept the invitation, you're welcome. You can stay as a Christian, you can stay as a Jew, but bear witness that we are Muslims. My respected brothers and sisters, I hope from these examples from the Quran, number one, you see that the Quran refers to the Christians and the Jews as people of the book, Ahlul Kitab. And number two, that the Quran commands the believers that we present to the people of the book, the Christians and the Jews, an invitation to come and worship Allah according to what the Quran says. Should they say that we don't want to accept this invitation, no problem, no compulsion, we don't have to go to war over that. We just say to them, bear witness that we are Muslims. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen to his word and implement the best of it. Anything that we have said in this video which is true is only by the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And anything that I have said that is not correct is because of my shortcoming. Please forgive me for that. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us, inshaAllah. Thank you very much for your time. Wa jazakum Allah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala.